right? People, Josh, have been coming here all day long.
They have been, no doubt about that, all day long.
People we've been meeting with, we've been talking to, we've been hearing their stories, such important stories about why people want to give a coat and why people want to give to the Forgotten Child Fund.
That's right, and our Brianna Arredondo joins us right now. She's been working on a story about those people, right?
Yes, today has just been such a great cause, as we've been saying, and a lot of people who I spoke with today just told me that this is something they want to get involved with year after year, and among one of those people was a foster mom who told me that this event holds very special meaning to her.
Also, being a foster parent for 16 years, it's one of my primary focuses, children. I'm only sending you one this week, but I wanted to make sure you have everything you need.
That's why Pamela Pierre says she was excited to get her office at Children's Dentistry involved in Coats for Kids this year.
We just asked for any donations that they had, and everybody tried to bring at least one, and then the doctor matched everything that we brought, so we got twice as many.
23 new and gently used coats, to be exact.
Okay. Where do I stop at? Got a few coats for you.
And it will help keep children warm.
To me, in the wintertime, when you start thinking about a child being outside and being cold, not having the proper clothing or things to keep them warm, it just goes right to the heart. It just cuts your heart.
Extra large boy, 14, 16.
As the donations keep rolling in, there's even more incentive to give.
Last year, we probably got 500 coats for him. And today, you can go to JCPenney and get an additional 25% off. So that'd be a great way to help.
Stop for a second, you might have to breathe. Yeah. The box is filled up with even the smallest givers showing compassion.
So give it to them. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Really appreciate it.
With our winters here now, you know, just like last winter, it was so cold, and there's people out here that, you know, don't have any coats or any, you know, clothes or means to keep warm, and just anything you can do to help.
And today the atmosphere has just been so cheerful. A lot of people telling me that they just want to give back to their community and help a child in need. And of course, you know, we're going to be out here for a long time, sure. So people have time to swing by. You know, everything's going to wrap up until around 7.
All right, Brianna, thanks so much. Brianna, just one of our members of our staff is out here. David Glenn is here. Dave Staley is here. Greg Funderburg is here. We have people all over the place, not just people from Channel 9, also firefighters and nurses and
policemen. So many people that are ready to take your donations here today, and they really just want to meet you, so come on down and see us here in the Hamilton Place parking lot.